You put some water, a good amount of water, into fire, and then you make sure that the water boils. Once the water reaches the boiling point, you will see bubbles. You will see it boiling as soon as you will start boiling in a little while. So let me get my unga. Unga is another name for flour. Actually, this is a farina I'm talking about. This is my unga, which is farina. Maize flour. So I have something I use to cook. I can see I'm not able to show you, but my water is boiling. Actually, it's not the boiling point. So these are my tools. This is what I use to cook my ugali cornmeal. So what you do, you put actually other people they have something like this which they use to stir, but I'm not gonna use it. I just use one thing because I'm able to, you see, you just pour sparingly, not so much, and you keep on stirring. The point of stirring is to make sure that we don't have lumps or flour in your ugali. There is something we call uji. Uji is porridge. If I do like this, I put some sugar, I'll drink some porridge. But this is how you make farina. You see? Now, the risk of cooking or making lumps is gone. So from here, I wait for this to boil a little bit. But now this is how you continue cooking. You put sparingly. I wanna be sure that I'm cooking in a good way. So you keep on stirring. Starting, yeah, it's almost now getting compact. So I put some more unga. Somebody was asking what is the amount that you put. Actually, there is no specific amount, and it all depends with the number of eaters, the number of people you are going to serve. So you see now from here, you can cook the normal way that you cook with this is a cooking stick. From here you see I'm able now to continue cooking the right way. This is just to make sure that there are no lumps in between, and to ensure that I remove all the bubbles. I remove some lumps. So from here, just continue to do like this so that I make sure that it is compact. I want make sure that it sticks together, huh? So my mom taught me that once you do like this and you are able to turn it that way, you know, it's not good. That's how you know that it's ready. But still, I want to cook some more because I want it to be compact enough, and I don't want to give people something that is not well cooked. Mm? So from here I can wait a little bit, you see, well cooked. I can still turn it. As I said earlier, my mom told me if you turn this way. My mom was the best cook. As everybody can say that his mom is the best cook. That is the norm. So I got to say it too. So you see, and actually this is how people test it, eh? You wanna know it's good, other people do like this, but wow, well, good. So I don't need this now. It into my farina. I have another one, but this one now is done. So I grab my plate, and I don't know if you are able to see here. You are not able to see, let me put here so that you can see. From here, you see, I can put like this. Oh yeah, my wrap is ready. My wrap is ready now. Ready to be eaten. Then you can put the fireplace off. And then I prepare some beef. Want to warm it, and I have some kale. Kale is what we call skumawiki. And now that's how we push through this quarantine. In there, we make sure that people eat well. Make sure you eat greens. I have greens here. Make sure you eat greens for your protection. And the beef is also good. That's a source of protein. If you are a vegetarian like me, you can eat beans and white meat. Thank you for watching. If you got questions, I will be coming in the next episode, but let me know what you think.